It's in the bag.
Simply no standards these days.
All right, get what you need. I'll cover the door.
Crowd the counter.
If you're sure that's what you want.
You want me?
Whatever you like.
Whatever you like.
Doesn't
it, evil?
It's in the bag. It's in the bag.
One at a time, one at a time.
I'm on it like ugly on an orc.
We should reach the Iron Throne building soon. Eltan wanted you to speak with a Saloonite monk helping out there, name of Rasad in Bashir.
If you're sure that's what you want.
The Iron Throne building doesn't look the same as the last time you were here, does it? The Council's using it to house refugees fleeing the Crusade.
It's in the bag.
You are more than welcome in my sight.
What is this? Is it truly you I see before me? And you, my friend. How have you been? I still mourn the loss of my brother, Gamaz. Some days are better than others. Imoen, will she survive? Who would do such a thing? Caelar? You say Caelar Argent tried to kill you? But why? You know there are few things I would not do for you, my friend. But I cannot help you with this. While most focus on Kalar's crusade, another, more subtle darkness is spreading. In the past few weeks, many servants of Selune have vanished.
Art thou certain foul play has occurred? These are turbulent times. Perhaps thy colleagues are engaged in their own business and simply neglected to tell thee.
I cannot deny the possibility, but it is a risk I cannot afford to take. Forgive me. As do I. May the Moon Maiden smile upon you in your efforts.
If you're sure that's what you want.
Yes, dear.
You need something? If you're sure that's what you want. I'm on it, like ugly on an orc.
What can it be now?
May I be of assistance? These refugees are my responsibility, and I believe I detect some tension here.
on it like ugly on an orc.
We're almost to Flaming Fist headquarters. There's a cleric being held there Duke Eltan thinks you might want to speak to. Though why anyone would want to talk to a madman like T-Ax is beyond me.
I'm on it like ugly on an orc. Now I'm on it like ugly on an orc.
What I can to help you.
Gather your party before venturing forth.
Do you know what I like about you? There must be something. I'd not wander the Flaming Fist's headquarters for most people.
It's in the bag.
I'm so tired.
More than mercenaries.
Declare yourself!
Thou art realizing this only now? Well, that was time well spent.
What can it be now?
It like ugly on an orc.
We're more than mercenaries.
On it like ugly on an orc.
order is what matters.
It's in the bag.
Bother and bother, never a calm spot, never a break.
Now I see why you're called the hero of Baldur's Gate. Bless you. Bless you. There are many here who'll not soon forget this. Here, take this gem. I hid it so Garrichin wouldn't get his greasy paws on it. Don't ask where.
Gather your party before.
If you're sure that's what you want. You need some? I'm on it, like ugly on an orc.
May you know the happiness of a warm hearth and home.
All right. I'll see you on the morrow. Word is your friend Imoen's mostly recovered from the Crusader poison, if you want to speak with her. Just remember, once you go up to your room, I'll leave to begin preparing for the journey. You won't get another chance to head out into the city.
I'm on it, like ugly on an orc.
Gather your party before venturing forth. You must gather your party before venturing
If you're sure that's
forth.
What you want.
So this is the Slayer of Sarevok, the hero of Baldur's Gate. How pleased I am to make your acquaintance. If it is security you desire, it would be prudent to reconsider your sleeping arrangements. I suspect the palace's weaknesses have become all too apparent to you of late. Strange. There lies within you barely a spark of divine consciousness, yet you bested your brother in blood. How? What is it that drove you to victory where so many others fell in defeat? Not all whom you face will be so vulnerable.
You do not see it yet, but another crossroads in your journey lies before you. One you will reach sooner than you think. The path you choose is of interest to me.
Your path could lead in many directions. You waver, unsure whether to claim credit for your deeds or to brush them aside. I can offer you clarity. But we can speak more of this in time when I am certain that you are the one I seek. Suffice it to say that I am a man who has lost much, but would regain some measure of what was taken from me. That is all you need know. I am not here to act, not yet. I am here to evaluate. Are you worthy? Is what you carry within enough? Are you strong enough to overcome the challenges you shall soon face? Only the passage of time will provide us answers. I'm curious to see how this plays out. I will be watching.
Oh, you're back. Sorry if I don't seem excited to see you. Poison really takes a toll. You don't know him? He said he was a friend of yours. We've known some pretty strange characters, so I didn't think it was weird to have someone pop in looking for you. Forget about him. We need to talk about your going to battle the Crusade. I know you think you have to do this, but I am telling you, you don't. Not only do you not have to do it, you shouldn't. I'm healing, but you need to heal too. Not just from fighting Sarevok. Those are just cuts and scars. But in coming to terms with, you know, what you are. Let someone else take care of the Shining Lady. Please. I knew you'd say that. I'm sorry. I can't go with you. You're the closest thing I have to family. I love you. You know that. But after Sarevok, I need things to be quiet. Just for a little while. I'll be back on my feet soon. I'm sure of it. I'm the one who ran away from Candlekeep to help you out, remember? I just need a little more time to rest and work with the weave. Promise me you'll be careful, all right? I don't know what I'd do if... We've just lost too many people, you know? I'm gonna leave now. Take care of yourself.
Tell Daddy, Duke Silvershield, about this. I've joined the Flaming Fist! No, really, I have. Not under my name, of course. Daddy would never allow it. But I'm in it now! Life as a noble is boring and stupid. I want to do something great with my life. And also get out of this dirty old city. And maybe meet some handsome soldiers. So, I'm going north with you. I know! All right, go back to sleep. I'll see you in... Oh, I guess you don't really have time to sleep now. I'll see you soon. Remember, whatever you do, don't tell Daddy about this.
Get ready to go. The early bird catches the evil worm. Isn't that right, Boo?
I got out of bed for this. And if there's one thing I'm loath to do in a bed, it's get out of it.
Your knee.
Whatever you like.
The sooner we reach Dragonspear Castle, the sooner we shall learn whether thy father spawned Caelar, as well as thee and Sarevok. That done and done.
Now what? I'm on it like ugly on an orc.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
I'm on it like ugly on an orc. If you're sure that's what you want.
Ah, the hero arrives.
I hope you slept well. You've a long road ahead.
Our prayers and hopes go with you. With your help, I'm sure we'll be able to stop the crusade before it grows any stronger.
The Flaming Fist travels with you under the command of Captain Corwin and Corporal Duncan. I'm sorry that Duke Eltan could not be present, but the ongoing crisis has called his attention elsewhere. Is there anything else you need before you depart? Is there anything else?
May the gods look upon you with favor.
You'd better get moving, unless there was something else. Let me guess. Skiz joins the Flaming Fist and plans to journey north with you. My dear Ski has many talents. Subtlety is not among them. First, I am aware of her grand plan. Bence Duncan, the man who arranged her entry into the fist, is a friend. I need her to grow up. I won't always be there to protect her. Though I like it not, it is my hope this will prove a learning experience for her. That service to the Flaming Fist will strengthen her body, mind, and character. Perhaps Captain Corwin might serve as a role model for her. I appreciate your coming to me with your concerns about Ski. Please accept this ring as a token of my gratitude. When her brother died, Ski changed. She got wilder, pushed me away. I am hopeful this experience will help change her priorities. One other thing, few of those traveling with you will know Ski's true identity. She is to receive no special treatment from the Flaming Fist. You, however, know exactly who she is. I expect my daughter return to me alive and unharmed. I am understood, I trust. Good. Speak with Captain Corwin by the main doors, and be on your guard. The trip north will likely hold dangers besides the crusade.
You are welcome here.
Look at all the people coming to wish us good fortune in our travels, Boo.
Just one. Feels like more than that sometimes. This is my daughter, Roma.
Let Minsk take care of this, little girl. In this world, there are many bats. Some are good bats, and those we shall leave unkicked. Some bats, however.
Lessons such as this are best left to the child's mother, Minsk.
They'll do what they have to. Exactly like that.
Oh, I like this little one. She has a fire in her belly.
That's right. Now give me a hug, Roma, and go to your grandfather. Mama's gotta get going.
This and that to be done. No time to stay and chatter.
So this is the great Feldurkin hero of Baldur's Gate.
How much longer must we wait? Crowds are fickle things. I know too well what can happen when moods turn sour.
What's this now? Hadrow knows the hero of Baldur's Gate?
We're all here for the same reason. The Council put the word out looking for those ready to fight against this Caelar, and we are always ready for a fight. Wait a minute, wait one Feldurkin minute. I don't care who you are, don't care if you're Lord the Hells 1-9, you're not taking our cleric away from us. Of all the cheek. I'll have your hide, you treacherous cow!
I think not. This is the hero of Baldur's Gate, remember? And as you remember that, recall what happened to Sarevok. Come, let us leave this giblet dwarf to wallow in his own filth. Thou veerest too far from the path of right. Correct thine steps.
There you are. The caravan's at the palace gate. We're ready to head to Dragonspear if you are.
Captain Shail Corwin and her aide, Corporal Bence Duncan, maintain order in the caravan from Baldur's Gate. Some who joined the expedition are unaccustomed to flaming fist discipline. Hard lessons are learned in the early days of the march north. The journey is slowed by the Crusade's victims. A multitude of broken, haunted men and women clog the coast way. When asked, they speak of fields set aflame, granaries ransacked, and family conscripted by the Crusade. Yet many characterize these hardships as necessary sacrifices in pursuit of a greater good. A strange acceptance, even admiration of Caelar Argent is disconcertingly common in those she has wronged. Some proclaim the Shining Lady a prophet, doing the work of not one but all faiths, all gods. Is it possible Caelar Argent's cause is a righteous one? Or is she engaged in a great deception to further her own agenda, as Sarevok once did?
And what of your goals?
Many souls were lost during the Dragonspear Wars. I will see justice done and restore them to the light.
Yes, quite honorable. But what makes you think yourself capable of achieving this, Caelar Argent?
You dare befoul my person with your magics?
Blood is something to behold. Not fear. Your divine heritage radiates from you. From which of your parents, mother or father?
Enough of these games and enough of your questions. Heffernan, get this mage out of my sight.
At once, my lady. We will have words about this, scarred one.
Perhaps.
Your companionship is not so great as I feared.